morning, BUHS. Today is Friday, March 8th, and it's a purple day.
Armed Services Vocational Aptitude Battery will be offered in the WRCC CUSA conference room on Wednesday, March 20th, beginning promptly at 9 a.m. and will run for 3 hours. That's a lot of hours. Interested students should sign up in the WRCC office with Joyce Rathburn or Ann Doran by Monday, March 18th.
Hey, listen up, juniors and seniors. The Keen Beauty Academy will be coming to the counseling department on April 4th during first period to talk about their cosmetology and aesthetics programs. Students who might be interested in these fields or in the Keen Beauty Academy should sign up for this visit with Mr. Stacy in the counseling office. We have some interesting trivia today. Let's go over to Casey.
Good morning, BUHS. Here is today's trivia. What is the largest airplane in the world? If you know this answer, please call extension 35E3. Stay tuned for the answer.
Call 3583 if you know the answer. Thank you, Casey. There is a blood drive starting on March 11th. FBLA will be in the cafeteria signing up students and staff to donate blood for the annual Red Cross blood drive. We have 60 open slots for blood donations. That's a lot of blood. Donors must be 16 with permission or older. Let's go over to the GSA for an important announcement.
Hi, I'm Zach.
And I'm Ursula.
And we're here on behalf of the BUHS Gay Straight Alliance.
We'd like to invite you to a meeting on Activity Day during Block 3.
We'll be in the CUSAC conference room in the Career Center. Don't forget to get a pass from Jim Stacy.
And
there will be pizza.
Awesome. The FBLA has extended their raffle sale through March 11th. Tickets are $1 each, or six tickets for $5.
That's a lot of tickets.
Please support FBLA by buying raffle tickets before the sale ends. You can win a variety of prizes, including gift certificates, a golf bag, lift tickets, and jewelry. Please support FBLA.
Attention to all FBLA members. All raffle tickets must be turned into Miss Vinci or Miss Cornell by the end of school on Monday, March 11th. Not turning them in is not an option. That's not a lot of options. Hey, Amity, how's the weather looking?
Thanks, Danny. So today there's a 90% chance precipitation with a high of 38 and a low of 23. Tomorrow it will be really sunny, 0% precipitation with a high of 47 and a low of 24. And then finally on Sunday we're going to have a high of 47, low of 34, 20% precipitation. Well, that's all. Back to the desk.
We still don't have a winner on that trivia, so if you know the answer, call 3583. And again, the question is, what is the largest airplane in the world?
Just so everyone knows, the Balfour representative has rescheduled and will be here on Friday, March 8th, during lunch periods in the cafeteria to take measurements for caps and gowns for seniors and to take orders for class rings and graduation announcements.
Hey, Germany Exchange members. There is a mandatory orientation meeting on Activity Day, March 13th, during Sea Lunch in Room 215. The final payment is due on or before Friday, March 15th. See Mrs. Sebastian for details. Sign up for the bake sale table for parent-teacher conferences by Thursday, March 14th. Sign up to work for one shift or many shifts from 4 o'clock to 7 o'clock and or bake. That's a lot of community service. Make sure to check your email for important announcements and BUHS Deutsch on the BUHS Google Docs site. Mandatory final student and parent meeting on Thursday, March 28th from 5:30 to 7 at room 215. We actually have a winner.
Mr. Angel.
We have a winner.
Mr. Angel's advisory. Come on down to the TV production room and claim your prize, which are oatmeal cream pies loaded with carbohydrates and sugars. Come on down. Now, over to Casey with the answer.
The answer is Mira, built in 1980 in the Ukraine, weighing 1,410,958 pounds. A normal plane weighs 12,500 pounds. Now back to the desk, please.
A lot of pounds. Anyway, over to Joe with sports.
Hey, sorry. Good morning, BYJS. Today in sports, the Colonels have a playoff today against Burton. If they win today, they might just go all the way, which would kind of be a big deal for the Colonels, who haven't made a trip to the finals since 1994. Let's take a look at an interview with Corey and Philip.
Hello, everyone. I'm Corey Andrews, and today I'm here with Colonels hockey star Philip Perkins. So, Phil, going over this whole season, what are your thoughts on the team, the way they brought you to the 17-3 record?
We had an excellent team this year. We had a good core group of seniors that are willing to put in the time, the effort, the passion to play the game, and we did good to bring us to that 17-3 record.
What was your most challenging game this season?
I have to say the U32 game was challenging. We did lose that game, but hopefully we'll see them later in the playoffs.
Do you feel like your team's ready to go and make that next step into the playoffs?
Yeah, we are ready, practicing hard. Came off a good win against Northfield on senior night. Looking forward to that first game.
Well, thank you today, Philip. That's all I have. Now back to the deck.
We have our winners right behind us. Okay. Girls tennis meeting for freshman JV and varsity will be held on March 12th at 3:30 in the CAF. BYJS Athletic Booster Club Sport Camp scholarship applications are available from Ms. Martell in the front office. So that's it for sports. Let's go back to the desk.
Thanks, Joe. Student guides are needed for the Thursday, March 14th parent-teacher conference. Hours will be from 3 p.m. to 7 p.m. Please sign up with Kathy Rouleau in the administrative office. These hours will count towards your community service. Also, if your group or club would like an informational table for a parent-teacher conference, you can sign up with Kathy Rouleau.
That's all we have for today, folks. Let's end with a clip from Renew. Stay classy, BYHS.
Hi, I'm Daisy, and I'm part of the Students for Renew, and part of our mission is to help survivors of UXO explosions rebuild their lives and assist them with care, such as giving them artificial limbs. In the country of Vietnam, UXOs are left over from the Vietnamese War. Small children may stumble upon them thinking they are toys, and they explode. Families also go out looking for these bombs because it is a good source of income. Students for Renew can help these Vietnamese people by providing them with care and education to stay alive. Donate a dollar to Students for Renew. Help us help them.
At age 20, Ho Van Ly has his own aspirations, like any other young adult. Discovering knowledge, leading his own life, becoming a helpful person. But he cannot enjoy even simple joys, such as playing soccer. Never again will he feel the ball touch his feet. A cluster bomb took his two legs and one arm. Forever. The injuries significantly prevent Lai from living a normal life. However, the bomb may have taken his legs and one arm, but it did not take his extraordinary will to live.